Okay, good morning everyone.
Good morning.
So did you see the changes in the portions for your first terminal examination? Yes, right. So chapter 3, 4, and from this chapter 4, from page number 263 to 269. Okay. So in the last class, we had just started this chapter, redox reaction, right? So for the entrance students, I just want to summarize the topic that we had discussed in the last class. Okay. So your classmates also help you to understand what all things we have learned. So what is redox reaction? Mehreen, you already learned about redox reaction, right? Yes. I can't hear you once again.
The reaction in which both oxidation and reduction takes place.
Yes. The reaction in which both oxidation and reduction take place simultaneously. It is known as redox reaction. Okay. So here we learned the different definitions for this oxidation reaction and redox reaction. Okay. We will start with oxidation reaction and reduction reaction. What all definitions we already learned about oxidation and reduction? We have learned that addition of oxygen is termed as oxidation. Then removal of hydrogen is termed as oxidation. Similarly, in the case of reduction, this removal of oxygen is considered as reduction. Then addition of hydrogen is also termed as reduction, right? So in this chapter, we will learn more definitions for this oxidation and reduction reactions. Okay, clear children? Niranjan, Tom Sinton. Yeah, now need it's a new chapter, chapter 8, redox reaction. Okay. Now need clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So in this chapter, we will learn more definitions for oxidation reaction and reduction reaction. Clear? So we will start with oxidation reaction. We already learned one or two definitions. First one is gain of oxygen, right? Gain of oxygen is considered as redox reaction, then oxidation. First point, gain of oxygen. Okay. You can write one example. Mg plus O2 gives 2MgO. This one is an example for oxidation reaction because oxygen is added to magnesium to form magnesium oxide. Okay. Then second definition, that is loss of hydrogen. Loss of hydrogen. So we can write the example 2H2S plus O2 gives 2S plus 2H2O. Here you can see this hydrogen, it is removed from hydrogen sulfide and it is converted to sulfur. That's the second point. Then the third one, Alandina, can you tell me the third definition? Do you remember? Which is the third one?
Addition of electronegative element.
Very good. Third one is addition of electronegative element. That is also considered as oxidation, addition of electronegative element. Shabri, can you tell me the example? Which one? Once again?
For the third one.
Not clear.
No, for the third one.
Yeah, third one, addition of electronegative element.
Mg plus F.
Very good. Mg plus
F.
F2. Okay. Mg plus F2. It will give MgF2. So this is also another definition for oxidation. Then next one. Emeline, can you tell me the fourth definition?
Removal of electropositive elements.
Very good. Removal of electropositive element. Removal of electropositive element. Okay. Then Lakshmi, can you tell me the example for this fourth one?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Two K4.
K4. Then?
Fe. Cn6.
Plus
H2O2.
H2O2.
Gives 2K3. Fe. Cn6.
Plus
2KO.
Okay. So here you can see the removal of electropositive element is also considered as oxidation. Look at this chemical reaction. Here in the reactant, it is K4. K is potassium, it's an electropositive element. And in the product, it is K3. That means one potassium that is removed from this reactant. Okay. So these four are considered as oxidation. First one, addition of oxygen. Second one, removal of hydrogen. Third one, addition of electronegative element. And the fourth one is removal of electropositive element. Then one more definition, that is loss of electron. Okay. Loss of electron. 1 minute. So the fifth point, loss of electron. Clear? This is clear, children? Tom Sinton, this is clear? Jewel?
Yes,
yes. Okay. The next one about the different definitions for reduction. Similarly, we can also write different definitions for reduction. Shall I move to next page? Yes or no? Yes. So the next one about reduction. So we will start with oxygen. Removal of oxygen. Removal of oxygen, that is considered as reduction. So we can write the example 2HGO. On heating, it will be converted to 2HG plus O2. Mercuric oxide, it will be converted to mercury and oxygen. Second one, addition of hydrogen. Okay, addition of hydrogen. Alina, can you tell me the example? Addition of oxygen.
CH2.
CH2.
Double bond.
Double bond.
CH2. Plus H2.
H2.
Yeast.
CH3. CH3, right? So ethene molecule, on reacting with hydrogen, it will be converted to ethane. The double bond breaks and each hydrogen atom will be added to each carbon atom. So second definition is addition of hydrogen. First one is removal of oxygen. Second one is addition of hydrogen. And the third one is removal of electronegative element. In oxidation, it is addition of electronegative element. Here it is removal of electronegative element. This is also considered as reduction, removal of electronegative element. So we can write the example 2FeCl3 plus H2 gives 2FeCl2 plus 2HCl. Here you can see there are three chlorine atoms in the reactant, right? Cl3. It is changed to Cl2. That means one electronegative atom, chlorine, that is removed from the reactant. Clear? Okay, then the next point, addition of electropositive element. Addition of electropositive element is also considered as reduction. So we can write the example HgCl2 plus SnCl2. It will give Hg2Cl2 plus SnCl4. To balance this reaction, here we will write 2. So here, this only one mercury is there in the reactant side, but in the product side, there are two mercury atoms, right? So one electropositive element is added. So these all considered as reduction. Then the last point is gain of electron. Gain of electron is also considered as reduction. Okay. Gain of electrons. So these are the different definitions for oxidation and reduction. Clear, children? This is clear for you?
Yes.
Okay. Just wait. So oxidation, addition of oxygen, removal of hydrogen, addition of an electronegative element, removal of electropositive element, loss of electron. No need to write again. We write the same point. And the reduction, that is removal of oxygen, addition of hydrogen, removal of an electronegative element, addition of an electropositive element, gain of electron. Okay. Then next, we already learned what is redox reaction, right? It's a combination of reduction and oxidation reaction. So we can write another definition for this redox reaction. Redox reaction involves two half reactions. Okay, redox reactions involves two half reactions. One involving loss of electron or electrons called half oxidation reaction, and the other involving gain of electron or electrons called half reduction reaction. So this redox reactions can be classified into two types, half oxidation and half reduction reaction. It's a combination of half oxidation reaction, half reduction reaction. In oxidation reaction, what happens? The loss of electron or electrons takes place, and in reduction reaction, gain of electron or electrons takes place. So that's about redox reaction. Completed. Then I told you to find out the type of reaction about some chemical equations, right, children? Did you find out? So these are the reactions. 2Na plus Cl2 gives 2NaCl. Then next one is 4Na plus O2 gives 2Na2O. Next one is 2Na plus S gives Na2S. These are the three chemical reactions. So we can identify what happens in each chemical reaction, oxidation, reduction, or redox reactions. Yes. What about the first one? 2Na plus Cl2 gives 2NaCl. Is it oxidation, reduction, or redox reaction? Anyone? What about the first reaction? 2Na plus Cl2 gives 2NaCl. You can refer the different definitions for oxidation and reduction or redox reaction. So you can tell me, what about the first one? Is it oxidation reaction, reduction reaction, or redox reaction?
Oxidation reaction.
Tell me.
Oxidation.
Oxidation. How can you confirm that it is oxidation? Yes. Which definition?
Addition of electronegative.
Okay, addition of electronegative element. Fine. So it is oxidation. Then what about reduction? We have learned one definition for reduction. Addition of electropositive element is considered as reduction. So what about this Na? Is it electronegative or electropositive?
Electropositive,
right? So the two process take place here, addition of electronegative element and addition of electropositive element. This one is electronegative and the other one is electropositive, right? Electronegative element and electropositive element is added. Now you can tell me, which type of reaction is this? Oxidation, reduction, or redox reaction?
Redox reaction.
Yeah, it's redox reaction. That's about the first one, right? It's redox reaction. Then second one, 4Na plus O2 gives 2Na2O. Which type of reaction? Jyoti, can you tell me which type of reaction is this? 4Na plus O2 gives 2Na2O.
Oxidation.
Why?
Oxygen is added.
Okay, oxygen is added, so oxidation. So what about Na? Electropositive element is also added. So?
So redox reaction.
Yes, this one also redox reaction. And what about third one? 2Na plus S gives Na2S. Gaya, can you tell me?
Redox reaction.
Yeah, this one also, redox reaction. Okay, so here sodium is oxidized. We can write in common. Sodium is oxidized due to addition of oxygen or electronegative element, right? Addition of oxygen or electronegative element. And similarly, chlorine, oxygen, sulfur, etc. are reduced due to addition of electropositive element which is the electropositive element in these three reactions?
Sodium.
Okay. That's why these three reactions are examples for redox reactions. Okay. So you have to think about all the definitions of both oxidation and reduction. Then you can able to identify which type of reaction is this. Okay. Clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So do you remember what's the last definition we have learned for oxidation and reduction? last definition. Yeah. Oxidation, that is loss of electron, right? And reduction, that is gain of electron. Now we are going to rewrite this chemical equation in terms of electron transfer. Okay. So can I rub this? Yes, right? Okay. So the same reactions. Now we are going to rewrite these equations in terms of electron transfer. What happens in each case? Electron transfer. So the first equation, 2Na plus Cl2 gives 2NaCl. 2Na plus Cl2 gives 2NaCl. So in this NaCl, what is the form of sodium? Does it exist as an atom or ion? Atom or ion. In NaCl?
Ion.
Ions, right? This one is Na plus and this one is Cl minus, isn't it? So we have learned that oxidation process, it is always loss of electrons. And when they lose electrons, they will become positive. Okay, they are donating electrons or they are losing electrons. So they are positive. Cation will be formed. Which one is the positive ion? Cation is positive ion and anion, that is negative ion. Okay, anion, that is negative ion. So here you can see that sodium 2Na, it is converted to 2Na plus. So what will happen here? Loss of electron or gain of electron? Sodium that is converted to Na plus. 2Na that is converted to 2Na plus. So gain of electron or loss of electron takes place?
Loss of electron.
Loss of electron. Okay. Loss of two electrons. Here 2Na it is converted to 2Na plus. So loss of two electron. Loss of two electron. So again we are moving to Cl2. Cl2 is converted to Cl minus. Here there is one 2 in common, 2NaCl. So this 2 is also for this chlorine atom. Okay. This 2 that is common for both Na and Cl. So here you can see that Cl2 is just converted to 2Cl minus. So what happens here? Loss of electron or gain of electron? Here, gain of 2 electron. Gain of 2 electron. So we can also say that the sodium, it is oxidized. Okay. Oxidation reaction take place in sodium due to the loss of 2 electron. And this chlorine that is getting reduced because gain of 2 electron. Clear? This is clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. We have learned the sodium is oxidized due to the addition of electronegative element. Here we are using different definition, but the concept is same. Okay. Sodium is oxidized due to the addition of electronegative element in the previous section, but here we are rewriting this equation in terms of electron transfer. So again, the sodium is oxidized, but the reason is different. Here we are considering the electron transfer. So due to the loss of two electron, the sodium is oxidized. Clear? So you can write the cation, it is positive. Here it is due to oxidation. Okay. Due to oxidation, always this positive ions are formed. Cations are formed. Then anion, it is reduction. Okay. Anion, it is reduction. Then we will go to the next example. Four Na. Okay. Na plus O2. Leave that four. Na2O. Na plus O2 gives Na2O. You can tell me what happens to sodium and what happens to oxygen. Here also the sodium Na, it is converted to Na plus, right? Na, it is converted to Na plus. So what happens here? Tell me.
Yes.
Yes, here also loss of electron, right? Here loss of electron and here gain of electron. So sodium is oxidized to sodium ion and oxygen that is reduced to oxide ion. Here it is Na plus and O2 minus. Then the third example is 2 Na plus S gives Na2S, right? So here also the same thing, sodium, it will be converted to Na2, that means here cation, so loss of electron and here it is gain of electron. So in all these three reactions, sodium is oxidized due to that donation or loss of electrons, and this oxygen, chlorine and sulfur, they are reduced due to the acceptance or gain of electrons. Clear? Sodium, that is loss or donate electrons, and this sulfur, oxygen and chlorine, they will accept electrons or gain electrons. Okay, so both oxidation and reduction take place in all these three reactions. This one is known as redox reaction. Clear, children? Any doubt? Do you have any doubt? Anyone? Tell me. Any doubt? This is clear for you. So no, yes, right? Okay, so we can also write this reaction as two half reactions. We learned that redox reaction, that's a combination of half oxidation and half reduction reaction, right? Redox reaction, that's a combination of half reduction reaction or half oxidation reaction, isn't it? 1 minute. Yes, this one is the definition. So the first reaction, that is 2Na plus Cl2, that gives 2NaCl, right? So we can write this equation as two half reactions. That means oxidation reaction separate and reduction reaction separate. How can we write this two reactions? Na, it is converted to, okay, 2Na. 2Na it is converted to 2Na plus, right? How it is converted to 2Na plus? What process take place there? Loss of electron or gain of electron?
Loss of electron.
Loss of electron. So we can write the two electrons here. Okay. Sodium ion, it is converted to, sodium atom, it is converted to sodium ion by donating two electrons. 2Na gives 2Na plus plus two electron. Similarly, we can also write the reaction of chlorine, Cl2, right? Cl2, it will accept two electron or gain two electron to convert it to the form Cl minus, right? Cl minus 2Cl minus. So these are the two half reactions for this single redox reaction. Clear? This one is redox reaction. First one is half oxidation and the next one is half reduction. Clear? That's why here in the definition, redox reaction involves two half reactions, one involving loss of electron or electrons called half oxidation reaction, and the other involving the gain of electron or electrons called half reduction reaction. This is clear for you? Any doubt? Anyone? Nothing, right? Jewel, any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So can you tell me the definitions of oxidation and reduction one by one? Nimita, any one definition for oxidation?
Addition of oxygen.
Addition of oxygen. Emeline, another one?
Removal of hydrogen.
Removal of hydrogen. Marin, another one? Unmute.
Addition of
an electronegative element. Okay, Malavika, next one.
Removal of electropositive element.
Removal of electropositive element. Then Agna, can you tell me the last definition of oxidation? Agna, are you there? No. Alina, can you tell me?
Loss of electron.
Then we are moving to reduction. So first definition for reduction, Naureen.
Removal of oxygen.
Removal of oxygen. Renil, another definition for reduction. Renil. Are you there? Pranav, can you tell me? Pranav.
Removal of electronegative element.
Removal of electronegative element. Okay. Anashwara, another definition?
Ma'am, addition of electropositive element.
Addition of electropositive element. Then Vinayak.
I'm gain of electron.
Gain of electron. Then any other point missing for reduction? Nothing. Okay. Then what is redox reaction? It's a combination of half oxidation and half reduction. Okay. Then next we are moving to another topic that you have already learned. That's about displacement reaction. Do you remember displacement reaction? You have learned different types of reaction in your class 10, chapter 1. Do you remember? Combination, decomposition, displacement, double displacement, oxidation, reduction, redox. Which is the criteria for this displacement reaction to occur? Any criteria there?
No reactive element displaces.
Very good. Yes. Only highly reactive metals can displace lesser reactive metals. And there is one series of metals that are arranged in the decreasing order of their reactivity. What's the name of that series? Come on, anyone?
Reactivity series.
Reactivity series or electrochemical series. Okay, so here we are using these all informations to learn. Next topic, that is commutative electron transfer reactions. Okay, commutative electron transfer reaction. Before that, one more thing. I think you already know the difference between this oxidation and oxidizing agent, right, children? Actually, this oxidation reduction are opposite to that of oxidizing agent and reducing agent. Okay, the terms are similar, but the their duty or function is different. In oxidation, loss of electrons by any species. We have learned that oxidation, that is loss of electrons by any species, but oxidizing agent, that is acceptor of electrons. Okay, here the ideas are different. Oxidation, that is loss of electron, but the oxidizing agent, that acceptor of electrons, they are acceptor of electrons. Again, reduction, it is gain of electrons by any species, but reducing agent, that is donor of electrons. So you must thorough with these four concepts. Okay, oxidation, loss of electron, reduction, that is gain of electron, but oxidizing agent, it is acceptor of electron, then reducing agent, that is donor of electron. Clear? Shall I move to next one? Okay. The next one about commutative electron transfer reaction. Okay. Commutative electron transfer reaction. Here, first we are going to discuss one experiment. We are going to place a strip of metallic zinc in an aqueous solution of copper nitrate solution as shown in figure. Okay, metallic zinc in an aqueous solution of copper nitrate. After 1 hour, following changes will be noticed. So what will be the color of, what is the color of copper nitrate solution? Due to the presence of copper, it is blue in color. You can see it in the image, right? The first one, zinc rod placed in copper nitrate solution. Here it is in blue color due to the presence of copper. Then after some time, the intensity of this blue color is reduced, right? That's the intermediate stage. And finally, this copper that is deposited over Cu2 plus is deposited as Cu. That means this copper is deposited on that zinc rod. Okay, copper in that solution, it will deposit it on this zinc rod. So what type of reaction is this? Yes, zinc displaces copper from copper nitrate solution. What's the name of this reaction?
Displacement reaction.
Okay, displacement reaction. So here one zinc rod that is placed in copper nitrate solution. After some time, this blue color of copper nitrate solution, it will fade and this copper is deposited on zinc, that's in brown color, right? So here we can confirm from this observation, the zinc can able to displace copper from copper nitrate solution. That means zinc is more reactive than copper, right? Zinc is more reactive than copper. Clear? So you can write the observations. Strips becomes coated with reddish metallic copper, then blue color of the solution disappears. Okay, strips become coated with reddish metallic copper and the blue color of the solution disappears. And if hydrogen sulfate gas is passed through the colorless solution, appearance of white zinc sulfate can be seen on making the solution alkaline with ammonia. This one is used for the confirmation of the presence of zinc sulfide. Okay, you can skip this part, but the remaining, you can see that the copper nitrate solution, that's in blue color, on reaction with zinc, it will be converted to a colorless solution. And this copper is deposited on zinc. So in this displacement reaction, this can also represent as electron transfer reaction. Okay, this can also represent as electron transfer reaction. So here you know that zinc, it will react with copper nitrate, that is CuNO3 twice. CuNO3 twice. Here the Cu, it will exist as 2 plus ion and here it is 2 minus. Okay, this is the reaction. So we can write these chemical reaction as electron transfer reaction. Zinc, that is converted to Zn2 plus. That means the product will be Zn zinc nitrate, Zn NO3 twice plus Cu. This will be the chemical reaction take place there. So you can write the reaction zinc that is converted to Zn2 plus by donating 2 electron. I told you when an atom donates electron, it will converted to cation, right? Here Zn, it is converted to the form of Zn2 plus. Okay, Zn, it is converted to 2 plus, Zn2 plus. That means it's a cation. So oxidation reaction will take place there. We can write the electron transfer reaction. Zinc gives Zn2 plus plus 2 electron. Clear? Zn2 plus plus 2 electron. Again, in the case of copper, it's already as Cu2 plus. It's in the form of ion, Cu2 plus, and it will accept 2 electron and convert it to Cu. So here acceptance of electrons take place. That's why here it is Cu2 plus plus 2 electron gives Cu. So we can write the displacement reaction also in terms of electron transfer, because both oxidation and reduction reaction is take place in this displacement reaction. Then can I ask one question, children? Is the reverse reaction possible? That means copper plus zinc nitrate. This is copper can able to displace zinc from zinc nitrate? Yes or no?
No.
Why?
It is less reactive.
Very good. This is not possible. The reason is that copper is less reactive than zinc. Okay. Copper is less reactive than zinc. So the reverse reaction is not possible. Clear? Here, loss of electron. Here it is, gain of electron. Then the next reaction that we can discuss in the next class. Okay. And I told you, yeah, Dulya.
Can you show the previous set?
This one, right?
Yes.
Okay. And I told you about one exam on tomorrow, right? Friday. That will be postponed to Tuesday. Okay, clear? Clear? Yes, exam on chapter 4, that will be on Tuesday. So you can learn this chapter thoroughly. Clear, children? Yes. Adulya, is this finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What about this one, children? Have you completed?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Then we can discuss the remaining reaction that comes under this competitive electron transfer reaction in the next class. Okay. If you have any doubt in any topic, you can ask me. Okay. Then let me take your attendance. Just wait. Okay. Then thank you, everyone. Bye. See you in the next class.
Thank you.
Thank you.